Shane Jones here with JupiterOne. First off, this is going to be a little bit different. So, yes, we're here to talk about cyber hygiene, but really some of that boils down to really what is that? What do I have in my environment? So if I can go into story mode for a minute. So imagine that you are walking into your home and you go to flip the light switch and you recognize power's out. It's dark. I can barely see 5 feet in front of me. I remember in my car I have a flashlight. I turn on my flashlight and I can see, right? I can see 5 feet in front of me. If I have a good flashlight, I might even see the entire room. But I can't see the whole of my house. I don't know if someone is lurking around the corner upstairs. I don't know if my family is home because I come home from a business trip. So stick with me. We're going to dive a little bit back into that story here in a moment. When we think about cyber assets, and if you think about your organization, and I love the opening here in the intro, if you think about your environment, you have an environment that spans devices, applications, right? It spans so much, and some of it you see, some of it you don't. Hackers see it. Hackers are looking for it. And by the way, hackers do not operate in lists. They are not going through an Excel spreadsheet looking for intrusion points into your environment. What they are doing is they're finding out how many degrees away am I from my target. JupiterOne can help with that. We actually arm you as a user of JupiterOne with a knowledge graph across the entirety of your environment. Now remember the story we talked about. 27% of companies, and this, I actually think this number's higher, but 27%, according to some stats, 27% of companies actually use multi-cloud today. Well, having said that, I can't have a point solution that only looks at one cloud, because that's just part of my cloud estate. That's just part of my attack surface. 79% of these companies have experienced at least one cyber event in their lifetimes. 79%. I'm sure if I took a poll, I'm not, but if I took a poll, you or someone you know close to you has experienced a cyber attack or an incident in the last 30 days. And when we talk about cyber assets, what does that mean? 165,000 cyber assets is the average that most organizations have. If you're a global enterprise organization, you're in the millions. If you're a startup, you may think you don't have a lot of assets, but what we've discovered is you're actually approaching 50,000, 100,000 assets yourself. And oh, by the way, I have a tool for that. I have a tool that goes after and actually addresses point solutions within your environments. And by the way, those tools are fantastic. They do a job. They have a job to do. They secure that workload. And we're surrounded by partners today in this expo hall who do great jobs at this. But let's keep talking. I could walk around and I can find a great security provider around application code. World class. I can keep walking around in my own environment and I can find someone that secures workloads. I can also find someone that does user endpoint security. Okay? Remember that story I was talking about with the flashlight? So now I have the flashlight, I turned it on, I'm walking around. Again, I can see what's in front of me, but I can't see what's next to me because there's a door there. I have no idea what's on the other side. So you know that feeling that you get when the house is dark, you gather in your family, keep that feeling in mind. It's not comfortable, right? It's not comfortable for your family, and frankly, it's not comfortable for your organization. So let's talk a little bit about cyber hygiene and ways in which you can address this in your organization. And when we talk about this, we at JupiterOne are firm believers, and you can find it in our culture, you can find it in our DNA, you can find it in how we operate and engage with customers and partners. We believe that security is a basic right. Well, what does that mean? When we talk about implementing core controls, again, great pointed solutions for that, that can help you put some core controls in place. Do a really good job of that. But this is an interesting one. Track your assets and monitor your assets. Now, I don't know about you, but I can remember days of having to do an inventory in one of the best databases ever known to man called a spreadsheet, and having to list out all of the assets in my environment for a particular department. Maybe it was DevOps, maybe it was compliance. And oh, by the way, now I'm going across the entire organization, and imagine if something happened. We did have an incident. Someone's breaking out binders, going through Excel spreadsheets, trying to figure that out of how big is my exposure. And oh, by the way, do I have everything? What about that new application that launched 3 weeks ago? Did we inventory that? So you really, really want to make sure that you can know what you have and see what you have in your environment. And I don't mean just at a point in time. I mean every day. Now that I know what I have, let's talk about reducing the risk through some data analysis. When we talk about data analysis in the terms of security and cybersecurity, there is structured awareness. And when I say structured awareness, we all know this very well, right? There's an operation in place, there's a team in place, there is a set of documents where we documented workflows. We know when an incident happens, who we're going to call in the call tree. But what about situational awareness, right? We're in a situational awareness opportunity right here among friends, right? There are people carrying around devices. People are accessing their emails. We're having conversations with each other. Having situational awareness and structural awareness in your environment is critical. How do you accomplish that as a security team? Well, you don't do it alone. So when we talk about hygiene and we talk about knowing what you have, we talk about securing it with the right access controls, we talk about being aware of your environment, both what you can control and what you can't. We need everyone doing that, not just the security team. You need to build a culture of security that starts with you and me, not the security team. It starts with us. And you can do that in such a way that you democratize that security. And oh, by the way, you also want to be mindful that you don't block innovation. You want to be an enabler for your organization. So, let's say that we've gone through those basic steps and we now have the environment. What's left? Are we manually maintaining all of this? The answer is no. We should absolutely find ways to automate. We should find ways to automate in such a way that if I do have an incident or I have an employee leave or something happens, that I am not having to reach out as a CISO to five different department heads waiting 4 weeks for folks to get back to me so that I know the blast radius of the impact. That's manual. That's time consuming. That's costing me money. And oh, by the way, it's costing us security. By automating it with a company like JupiterOne, you can now, within minutes and hours, have access to that entire cyber asset universe and actually have visibility of all of those assets and then action upon them. So now I'm going to take you back to the story. Remember, we were talking about we're in the dark. We've got the flashlight. I can see in front of me. What do I see? When I point the flashlight, I see in the direction I'm pointing. I'm not seeing to my right or my left. Can't see behind me. It's a pointed solution. You know that feeling you get when the power, whether it was a bad storm that came through, what have you, that feeling that you get when the lights come on and your house wakes up, it's all connected. You hear the sounds. You hear Alexa go off, right? You hear all the buttons go off and click and all of the electronic devices that are connecting. You've already gone through the house and flipped on light switches because you were paranoid, so the lights all come on. That's what JupiterOne does for your environment in the enterprise. We help you turn the lights on. And by the way, we don't just do it in one silo. We do it across your organization. So whether that's applications, whether that's users and personas, whether that's workloads, whether that's servers and workloads, right? Cloud identity, infrastructure, JupiterOne connects those dots. So now you actually have a complete view of your entire asset estate. So key takeaways. Implement core controls. Absolutely necessary. And by the way, with JupiterOne, when you get that exposure, you can also see vulnerabilities. Do that data analysis. There's some things that we can do from a use case perspective around that. I won't dive into it now, but build data analytics into your cybersecurity practices. That way you're not necessarily going through reams of paper, you're not going through Excel spreadsheets. You're getting that in real time. And build community across your organization. Security itself should not be a silo. Security is a community of all of us, and we all have roles to play. And oh, by the way, use that data, use that automation to help you scale your business, and frankly, to help you innovate. Because now you actually have that visibility, you can manage, do cost management and controls. And there's so much more, by the way, I could mention around compliance and other things. But I will let you attend our booth and ask questions. It's behind you. 231 JupiterOne, green pants, look for us. When you approach our booth, you'll have an opportunity to have some discussions around different use cases. I would highly encourage you to take a look at the SCAR report, as well as the Cyber Defense Matrix. There are a lot of organizations, remember when I made the statement that JupiterOne believes that security is a basic right? Many organizations are actually adopting some of the very frameworks that JupiterOne was built on. So stop by our booth. We have copies of that for you. Take a peek at it. And if you want to try it out for yourselves, you can certainly reach out to us. With that, I will say thank you.